एक्सरसाइज 14B क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 यू कैन सॉल्व, क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 आई एम सॉल्विंग. क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज एंगल 1 एंड एंगल 4. नाउ एंगल 1 वी आर हैविंग हियर एंड एंगल 4 वी आर हैविंग हियर. सो एज आई टोल्ड यू दिस टू एंगल्स आर सेट टू बी वर्टिकली अपोजिट एंगल. So these are vertically opposite angles. Second question is angle 4 and angle 7. So this is your angle 4 and this is your angle 7. Now angle 4 is on this side but angle 7 is on opposite side. And you know very well that if angles are on opposite side, that means they are alternate angles. So you have to write that angle 4 and angle 7 are alternate angles. Then third is angle 10 and angle 12. So this is angle 10 and this is angle 12. So these two angles are said to be vertically opposite angles because, as I told you, when two lines are intersecting each other, these angles are equal and they are said to be they are known as vertical opposite angles. So similarly, angle 10 and angle 12, these two are vertically opposite angles. Write completely vertically opposite angles. As I'm not having space here, that's why I'm writing V.O.A. You have to write vertically opposite angles. Then next is angle 7 and angle 13. So angle 7 and angle 13. This is your angle 7 and this is your angle 13. Both angles are present on the same side of line, on this line. That means in this direction, angle 7 we are having here, angle 13 we are having here. So as I explained you that if you are having angles on the same side, on the same side, that means the angles are corresponding angles. And as you can see, angle 7 is inside these lines and angle 13 is just outside. So angle 7 and angle 13 are corresponding angles. Then next is angle 6 and angle 8. Angle 6 and angle 8. So this is your angle 6 and this is your angle 8. I think you can solve this vertically opposite angle. So angle 6 and angle 8, vertically opposite angle. Then angle 11 and angle 8. Angle 11 and angle 8. So this is your angle 11 and this is your angle 8. These two angles are on the same side and they are not corresponding angles. Why? Because for corresponding angle, you must have one interior angle and one exterior angle, as angle 7 and angle 13. As you can see, angle 7 is interior angle while angle 13 is exterior angle. But angle 8 and angle 11, angle 8 and angle 11, these two are interior angles. So angle 8 and angle 11 is co-interior angles. Co-interior angles. Then you can also write allied angles as given in your books. as given in question, allied angle. Then next is angle 7 and angle 9. Angle 7, angle 9. Again, same vertically opposite angle, you can write. Angle 4 and angle 5. Now you are having angle 4 here and angle 5 here. So you are having a common arm. This is common arm. And you are having two angles, angle 4 and angle 5. And they are making a straight angle, 180 degree. So angle 4 and angle 5 are adjacent angles. Angle 4 and angle 5 are adjacent angles. Then angle 4 and angle 6. Angle 4 and angle 6. Again, these angles are not corresponding angles. Why? Because angle 4 and angle 6, these two angles are on the interior side of lines. That means angle 4 lies with this line and angle 6 lies with this line. And as you can see, angle 4 and angle 6 both are within these lines. But for corresponding angle, you must have one angle in interior side and interior portion, and one angle in outside or exterior portion. But angle 4 and 6 both are inside, just like angle 11 and angle 8. So angle 4 and angle 6, these are co-interior angles, or you can also write allied angles. Then next is angle 6 and angle 7. So you are having angle 6 here and angle 7 here. They are making a straight angle. So angle 6 and angle 7 are adjacent angles. Angle 2 and angle 13. Angle 2 is here and angle 13 is here. Again, they are on the interior side, interior portion with these two lines. So angle 2 and angle 30. Angle 2 and angle 13 are said to be allied angles or co-interior angles. So I have explained you question number 2. Then question number 3. In question 3, these arrows are indicating that lines are parallel, and we have to find whether angles are equal or not. So as you can see, we are having here angle A, angle B, angle C and angle D. So first thing is that angle A and angle B, these two angles are on the same side, and one angle A is interior and angle B is exterior. So if you are having angles on same side and you are having one interior angle and one exterior angle, that means angles are corresponding angles. So angle A will be equals to angle B. Clear? Angle A will be equals to angle B, and the reason is corresponding angles. Then angle B will be equals to angle C. The reason is vertically opposite angle. Now tell me, if angle A is equals to B and that angle B is equals to C, so directly we can write angle A is also equals to angle C. So for the final conclusion, angle A is equals to angle B and angle B, which is also equals to C. So we are getting a relation that angle A equals to angle B equals to angle C. Then next question. Now in the second question of question number 3, we have to find that which angles are equal. So the first is x and y. Angle x will be equals to angle y. The reason is vertically opposite angle. Now this is angle k. Now y will be equals to angle l. Y will be equals to angle l, and as you know that y is on this side and while x is on this side, that means angles are on opposite side. So they are corresponding angles. I have told you that if one angle is on one side and another angle is on opposite side, the angles are known as alternate angles. But for the corresponding angle, you should have angles on same side. So angle y and angle l will be equals to each other. So you have to write that angle y will be equals to angle l, and the reason is alternate angle. Then this x and l will be equal, angle x will be equals to angle l. Now angle x and angle l both are on the same side, and angle x is exterior while angle l is interior, so corresponding angle. Now this angle l will be equals to angle n. This angle l will be equals to angle n. The reason is vertically opposite angle. Then this angle n will be equals to angle r. Angle n and angle r both are on the same side, and angle n is interior, angle r is exterior. So if you are having angles on the same side, that means the angles are corresponding angles. So angle n will be equals to angle r. The reason is corresponding angle. Clear? Now angle m will be equals to angle k, vertically opposite angle, and that angle k will be equals to angle q. The reason is that angle k equals to angle q. The reason is corresponding angle. So angle x is equals to angle y. So first we have to write angle x equals to angle y. Now this angle y is equals to angle l. Okay, so angle l. Now this angle l is equals to angle x, which I have already written here. So angle l is equals to angle n, and that angle n equals to angle r. Clear? So from these angles we got that angle x, angle y, angle l, angle n, angle r, these are equal. Now second observation is angle m is equals to angle k, while angle k equals to angle q. So these three angles are equal to each other. So like this you have to identify that which angles are equal and which are not.